Hello all, my name is Krish Nag and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this particular video, we are going to see how to handle category features if it has high labels or high number of categories. That basically means if it has high cardinality ratio, at that time, how do I handle those categories? I've already created one video on performing this kind of work. And again, there are various techniques to handle category features. If you have not seen that particular video, the link is basically given in the description or in the right hand side of the screen itself. Please go and watch that first, because this is the another technique what I'm actually going to perform. To begin with, guys, let us just revise some of the concepts. Suppose if we have a category features, usually there are two type of category variables, okay? One is the ordinal category variable, the other one is the nominal category variables. If I take some example of ordinal category variable, that basically means you can rank those categories. Okay, so the example is rank of the students in class, the education that you basically have. You know, suppose I consider that PhD is greater than master's, master is greater than bachelor's, bachelor is greater than high school, and all this kind of conditions. So these are some of the examples of ordinal categories. When I talk about ordinal categories, the most common encoding technique that we use is something called as label encoding. But in the case of if I take nominal categories over there, rank does not matter, you know. So if I take an example, it may be gender, male and female, it may be state names, country name, you know, different company names. So all this kind of information, you cannot rank them, you know. Yes, suppose if I want to rank countries based on GDP, so that GDP, based on GDP, if I'm ranking them, that becomes an ordinal ranking, okay? So these are some of the things. But if I just have some features where I just have country name, state name, I cannot rank them. So for that, I'll call them as a nominal variables. And again, there are various techniques to, convert that into dummy variables or there are various ways to handle those categories also. So always remember, whenever you are given a problem statement, first of all, you need to categorize them, whether it is a nominal category or an ordinal category. In my previous video, I have already shown how to handle that with the help of some techniques, which was basically implemented by the team who had won KDD Cup Orange Challenge. Okay. So in that, what they had done is that they had just taken the top 10 most frequent categories, and they had actually converted that into dummy variables using the one-hot encoding. For all the remaining thing, they just replaced, they just skipped it, in short. The accuracy was good, they won the competition, and yes, if it works in Kaggle, it is not necessary that it will work in the real world scenario. So you should know all the different other techniques. Today in this particular video, I'm going to show you a technique which is called as count or frequency encoding. Now in this particular technique, I'll show you the practical implementation with a very good example. I'll show you how it is done, what are the things that are basically required, what is actually count or frequency encoding. And then we'll try to also understand, the base thing is that what are the advantages and the disadvantages of this particular technique also. So please make sure you watch this video till the end, because it'll definitely give you a whole lot of different techniques to handle category features. So that was the basic question by many of my subscribers, and I'm going to do that. And in the upcoming videos, I'm again going to show you some different techniques. I'm going to combine both ordinal categories and nominal categories. So make sure that you see the practical applications. So let us go ahead and try to see the practical implementation in short. So we'll continue the discussion regarding the count of frequency encoding. We'll try to understand what exactly is count of frequency encoding. And again, guys, this is one of the technique of handling category features. So let's go ahead and try to understand. A count of frequency encoding is basically applied to a category feature where you have higher number of labels, higher number of categories. So it is also basically called as high cardinality. So let us just try to see an example, okay? Suppose let me consider that I have some category feature which has high number of labels, and suppose if I try to perform one hot encoding, what will be the problem with that is that we will create multiple labels, right? Many number of labels in the dimensions. Now what does count of frequency encoding say is that we replace each label of the category variable by the count, and this is the amount of time each label appears in the data set, or the frequency, this is the percentage of observation within that particular categories. Both are basically equivalent. So what we'll do is that I'll take a problem statement over here. I'll try to find out how many number of categories are present in that particular categories itself, category feature itself.
And then I'll replace each label with the count of that particular variable. Again, guys, this is one of the technique. We, you know, whenever we are competing in some Kaggle competition, definitely one of these particular techniques will be useful. So we should know many number of techniques that we need to solve, you know, the category features in short. So let us go ahead and try to see a particular example. You understood the aim. Our aim is basically to replace the label of category feature, category variable by the count. And this is basically the amount of times it each label appears in the data set. So what I'm going to do is that, first of all, let me consider one problem statement. So I have a data set which is called as Mercedes-Benz data. And again, you can download from this particular link. From this, as soon as I opened this, I found out two features that are having the high cardinality ratio. So I took up X1 and X2. Now I'll just go and execute it. So this is, I've basically executed it over here. If I go and see my shape, basically says that it has 4,200 records and two categories. Now, suppose I initially, as you all know, everybody knows one hot encoding, right? So I'll just write down one hot encoding over here. I'll just convert this into Markdown. Okay. Now, suppose if I'm performing one hot encoding, what will be the problem? Okay. Now, you know that how to perform one hot encoding. I will just use get underscore dummies and I'll use DF. Now, when I try to find out the shape with the help of one hot encoding, what is happening is that if I try to execute it, you can see that initially my columns were only two, right? Now 69 columns has been added more. Yes, I have to draw two columns, that is X1 and X2. Then it will become 69. But just understand how many number of dimensions is getting increased. Okay, this is very, very bad in short. Now what I'll do is that after that, let's see how to perform this counter frequency encoding. And again, our aim is basically to replace each label of the category variable by the count. This is the amount of time each label appears in the data set. Okay. So for that, what I'm going to do is that first of all, I'll try to find out how many unique values are present in X1. So you can see that in X1, I have 27 labels. In X2, I basically have 44 labels. Okay. And I want to display, you know, in a different way, you can basically write this kind of code also if you want. Again, the main thing is to make you understand, and you know, you'll be able to see in a very good way. So basically I'm printing it such that any user can basically read it over here. After that, what I'm doing is that I am basically taking the X2 variables. Okay. And now our aim, as I said, that I need to find out how many times the label is present in the records. For that, I'm going to use something called as value underscore counts. I'm converting this into dictionary because there is a reason I'll convert this into dictionary, because that will help me to do the mapping later on. So let us just execute and see. Now, as soon as I executed in X2 variables, right? If I consider X2, there are various categories like AS, AE, AI, M, R, N, and many more. Okay. Now, this is basically displaying me the count on the right hand side. This is the my label name. Okay. So you can see all the count over here present in that particular data set with respect to this particular labels. And this is my label key in short. Now, after this, what I'll do is that I'll store this whole value into one variable called as df underscore frequency underscore. Then if I want to apply this whole dictionary mapping into my X2 function, I'll just use a map function, because at the end of the day, I have to replace all the labels inside my X2, okay, into the count, right? So if initially, if I see over here, okay, before executing this instruction, if I see df.x2, the dot head, suppose here you can basically see that I'm having AT, AV, N, and all the category features, right? Instead, I can also see like this. Let me just see the top 100 records. Now here you can see in X2, I have AT, AV, N, EE, SS. So what we are trying to do, we are trying to replace this with the count. Okay. So for that, what I'm doing is that I'll just use df.x2.map, and my frequency mapping is basically present. So this frequency mapping has for which categories, what is the label count? Okay. So that is what I'm actually trying to do over here. And I'll try to execute it. And here you can see that each and every categories has got replaced by this count. Initially my X2 was like this. Over here, now my X2 is something like this. Again, there are some advantages and disadvantages that we'll discuss. First of all, the advantage is it is very, very simple to implement. Okay. The second advantage is that we do not have to create extra feature dimension space, and as you know, that curse of dimensionality, right? It is preventing that. But again, this may not be the perfect way. Sometime it may work, sometime it may not work. It completely depends on the data set. And since I am referring all these things, I've researched all these things to various Kaggle competitions, various exploration that I've actually done, you know. So some of the disadvantages is that if some of the labels have same count, then they will be replaced with the same count itself. So they will lose some valuable information. So that what does that basically mean? Suppose I have two categories over here, AT and AV. Suppose this label counts are 500, 500. Okay. So if I try to convert with the help of label count, then both this variable will become, both these categories will become same, right? So that basically means we are losing some kind of information. Okay. Apart from that, add somewhat arbitrary numbers through therefore weights to the different labels, and they may not be related to the predictive powers. So these are some of the advantages and disadvantages. Again, if you want to read more information, you can basically see this link in the Kaggle, and what are the, you know, expert basically have told about this all techniques. But this is one of the way where you're just converting your labels into a number encoding or a count label in short. Okay.
So I hope you like this particular video, and I hope you understood what is counter frequency encoding, and we have actually seen a very good examples. So this is all about this particular video. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a great day ahead. Please do subscribe to this channel if you have not already subscribed. Share with all your friends. I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you one and all. Jai Hind.